What does this sensational and violent act mean to the Republic of Armenia and the Armenians here in the valley? KC's Paul Chaderjian, who was working in Armenia when the current government was elected, is in the newsroom now with the story. Paul.
Stephanie, as you know, Armenia is about to enter its fourth millennium of history after having spent most of the last 800 years under foreign rulers, the Turks and the Soviets. For the last decade, the nation is rebuilding itself from the ashes of glasnost and perestroika. Those are the reconstruction agendas set forth by former Supreme Soviet Mikhail Gorbachev. Those are agendas which crumpled the Soviet Union.
This sensational outbreak of violence yesterday, some are attributing to the growing pains of a new republic. After the collapse of the Soviet Union, the 15 former Soviet republics, including Armenia, were left with virtually no economy. Now, as millions in the region try to survive in their post-Soviet and pseudo-capitalist economies, their struggles, the poverty, unemployment and corruption are seldom mentioned on the nightly news until a sensational crime like this is caught on tape.
That's why I'm amazed by this.
Dr. Dikran Kuyumjan is the director of the Armenian Studies Program at Fresno State.
People have been upset saying, how can you shoot a parliamentarian or the speaker of the parliament or the prime minister, in this case in parliament? Let's not forget that our president, his name was Kennedy, was shot in front of television in down in Dallas, Texas. We had another famous president named Lincoln, just to mention two of the most prominent presidents who bit the bullet, as we say.
Kuyumjan says the fact that the administration didn't topple after the assassinations of Armenia's prime minister and parliament speaker should prove to Valley Armenians that the democracy of their new homeland is strong.
I hope the country will heal. I hope that the president will be able to quickly appoint an acting prime minister and that the country can get on with its business, and it has a lot of business to get on with.
In a televised statement, one of the gunmen told viewers that they were prompted to take action because they couldn't make ends meet. They said that children did not have shoes or textbooks to go to school with, and that Armenia's economy had collapsed and social tension had reached an unthinkable height. Tonight at 6, what will the murders of legislators mean to the election of the new Catholicos of all Armenians? Find out at 6. Reporting from the newsroom, Paul Chaderjian, KC 24-Hour News.
All right, thank you, Paul.
The day after 8 lawmakers were assassinated in the Armenian capital of Yerevan, there is hope in the Central Valley now about the strength of the homeland's new government. Paul Chaderjian is in the Satellite Center tonight with an update. Paul?
But from senior parishioners at local Armenian churches to the White House, from Governor Davis to Congressman George Rodanovich, everyone is expressing their concern tonight at the violent outbreak in Armenia's parliament. The gunmen say they were prompted to take action because of poverty, corruption in government, and the fact that their country had fallen to pieces and turned into a motherland from where everyone was trying to flee.
And as we see today with the thing resolved and the assassins under arrest, and waiting for trial, that democracy is alive and healthy in Armenia, just as it is in the United States. I think that's very encouraging.
8 people dead in a sensational murder broadcast on national television. But the call for a coup did not collapse the fragile and fledgling 8-year-old Republic of Armenia. Overshadowed by the violence was the election of a new leader of the Armenian Church, a man who will lead the 6 million-plus global population of Armenians as Catholicos.
This is not the moment to talk about who should have been the candidate. We now have a Catholicos. Let's be 100% behind him, as we are going to be 100% behind the government of Armenia.
Catholicos Karakin II will be the 132nd Catholicos of the 1700-year-old Armenian Church. He will be consecrated.